in terms of competition, everybody should be embracing competition. There goes the adversity.
Yeah.
So if you see a competitor in your space, embrace it, or go to a space that's old and rich that hasn't been disrupted.
Right. Disrupt the shit out of it.
That's right. And that's what we did with the life insurance industry.
Really?
Yeah. Because it's an old, boring thing. Let me ask you this question. When I say, like, if I would ask you to put a picture in a dictionary of a life insurance agent, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go based on age, gender, and ethnic background.
Okay.
Gender, male or female?
Male.
Okay. Older or younger?
60.
Okay. Right. Ethnic background?
I'd probably just say Caucasian.
Oh, exactly.
Yeah.
Older Caucasian male is typically with inside the insurance industry.
Yeah. I mean, I see a lot of them on LinkedIn.
Well, look at me. I've been doing this for 25 years now.
Right.
Do I look like a typical insurance?
No, not at all. And you just made a huge ass exit.
Right. So in other words, that's why we disrupted our industry by introducing and recruiting and selling to the multicultural, middle-income demographic.
Right.
And so today we have over 50,000 agents across the country, of which I mentor 5,000 of them.
Amazing.
With inside the company. And we have like internal competition with inside the other companies with inside the company.
Yeah, yeah.
Because my top line revenue within the company is $40 million.
That's amazing, right? Dude. That's
so
amazing.
So I'm not the only one, though.
Right.
So we have a good, healthy adversity.
Right.
Competition, adversity is your friend. But if you have a breakdown in morals, values, and principles, and breaking the law, cutting corners, you're going to have the worst side of adversity.
100%. Sets you back.
Yeah, it sets you back. And it can potentially sap your confidence.
Yeah, I agree. That's crazy. Yeah, well, so going off that with this exit, so how are you going to portray to scale? Like, what's your goal to scale? How are you going to achieve that?
Yeah, so we already have a scalable model. We have not, we've flexed a lot with social media.
Yeah.
That's been our way for, look at what Patrick's doing right now with Valuetainment.
Right, yeah. It's grown massively.
Yeah, but Valuetainment was started off as a YouTube channel just to teach us how to run the insurance agency.
Oh, was it really? I didn't even know that.
But it's based on values and principles and systems and processes.
Right.
That, you know, how to negotiate your first lease, how to hire your employees, how to train your sales team, how to teach you guys sales, how to teach you guys customer service. So all the things of running a business and our model, Patrick just put it in general terms and general method, but he sent it to us in his YouTube channel.
Yeah.
But the rest of the world started picking up on it.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah,
I like that. I like that. I like that. I like that. How to go, right? And so like, hey, that's because there are public videos.
Right.
So instead of more the how-to though, what the biggest thing that Patrick did put out was the crusade of being a flag carrier for America, being a flag carrier for capitalism, be a flag carrier for entrepreneurs.
It's important. It's very important, especially with the kind of puppet masters, I would say, like trying to really direct the way people think, especially with social media now.
Yeah,
you got a bunch of individuals in America watching social media 24 hours a day, unless they're sleeping.
Yeah,
and they can really just make them think a specific way.
Yep,
and I think that individuals like Pat, I think that can really help especially the younger generation, because all my friends, I'm gonna be honest, I love them, but they're very one way thinkers, and that's how they've been raised. You know, they're gonna go to school, get a job,
still,
retire,
still institutionalized,
and die, and that's how it kind of goes. And it's I don't know what it was at the very start, but I just never thought like that. I couldn't think like that when I was growing up. It just wasn't. I knew that there was more potential in this world to do something great when you can actually make a difference, because you only set to the limitations that you set yourself.
Yeah.